Dear guests, honorable participants of the policy dialogue, it is a great pleasure to be virtually with you for this important event on the next generation democracy. This is a very topical theme in view of the, I hope only temporary, decline of democracies in the world. Democracy is not a given. It has been put to a stress test, both in COVID, but also as a result of new challenges, such as the digital transition. Democracy relies on citizens' engagement to thrive and develop. As Slovak President Mrs. Čaputová said recently in Aachen, we should not spend too much time discussing how our democracy is being undermined today. We know it. Instead, we should talk about what we are doing to defend it, promote it, and to make it stronger. We need to foster citizens' participation. To achieve this, we need a strong, independent civil society that will nurture an open and pluralist space for debate in the democratic life of the EU. Engaged, informed and empowered citizens are the best guarantee for the resilience of our democracies. Rights to express views and opinions also come with responsibilities. One of them is to properly inform and be properly informed in the first place. The digital revolution has brought new opportunities for citizen engagement in our democracies. More and more citizens get their information and engage in the democratic process online. But it has also presented new challenges as disinformation is prevalent online and particularly so during the coronavirus pandemic. With this in mind, we have adopted the European Democracy Action Plan in December last year. Its aim is to equip our democracies better against today's threats. As regards disinformation, we address the sources such as foreign actors, the channels such as transparency and accountability of platforms, and the targets, us, the citizens. On citizens, we put a strong emphasis in particular on promoting media literacy. We have to help citizens identify disinformation within the EU and beyond. EU funds and opportunities are available under the EU Youth Strategy, Citizenship Education, the Creative Europe Programme and the Equality Agenda to foster access to democratic participation and trust in democracy. The new Citizens' Equality Rights and Values Programme will support citizen engagement, democracy and promote a culture of values in the EU. 1.5 billion euro is destined to projects on the Union values strand that protect fundamental rights and democracy. Civil society organizations play a key role in upholding the common values on which the EU is founded. The rule of law, fundamental rights and democracy. But over the past few years, we are seeing laws and government actions that hamper their work, their independence and effective operations. The Court of Justice highlighted that the right to freedom of association constitutes one of the essential bases of a democratic and pluralist society. It includes the rights of civil society organizations to seek, secure, and utilize resources. Civil society organizations in some EU countries are also sometimes subject to intimidation and harassment, including abusive lawsuits. This is a major threat to our democracies. So we are now looking at how to protect journalists and civil society against abusive litigation initiated to silence them. We are gathering the elements that will shape the forthcoming initiative against strategic lawsuits against public participation. Another key issue and responsibility for all of us is to make sure that citizens are able to distinguish what constitutes political advertising when they browse online. Along with civil society and responsible authorities, they must be able to distinguish the source and purpose of political advertising. This is why we are working on a proposal on transparency of political advertising. This is vital for democracy, not just in times of elections. On another note, we will also continue supporting research to develop a better understanding of people's dissatisfaction with democracy and how it can be addressed through democratic innovation. I was delighted to be present on the 6th of October at the inauguration of the new Competence Center on Participatory and Deliberative Democracy of the Joint Research Center. It is an important new resource to help the Commission strengthen citizen engagement in policymaking in democracy. Last but not least, we need to foster citizen participation in public decision-making. This will help us deliver better policies, strengthen democracy, and build trust in institutions. The Conference on the Future of Europe provides citizens with the opportunity to make proposals to shape future EU policies. I am very much looking forward to what the conference will yield. We will surely look at ways to exploit the citizens' ideas and suggestions in this context. And I am confident that your ideas and insights at today's summit will stimulate our collective efforts to engage citizens more and more efficiently in our democratic debates. And I thank you for them. I wish you a good discussion today.